The Raiders were at full strength, all of their internationals backed up after Friday's test. But after only 2 minutes, each fullback David Peters had crossed for the first points of the match. Late in the half, Stephen Camp made it two, and the Roosters had a handy lead at the break. It didn't take long for the onslaught to resume. This time,
after
the night was
Parramatta. It took them a while, though, 10-6 at half time.
But this try early in the second half opened the game right up. 8:30 and another team moves into semi-final contention. One club of eastern suburbs kept their slim semi-final hopes alive with a 30-6 demolition of Parramatta. Halfback Gary Freeman and captain Craig Salvatore were instrumental as the Roosters outclassed the Eels, scoring 6-5-1. Under the count,
the sign. Fireworks have started in the background. Here they are.
A different performance from the Roosters in the first half compared to the second.
Yeah, it was a game of two halves, Graham. I thought that, but the game sort of went with possession. It was all from George, and early in the game, there's a lovely cut-out ball too from Wayne Collins out wide. But sort of synonymous with the flow of possession was the inability of the other side to kill the football in movements. But the reverse happened in the second half. It was all Eastern Suburbs.
And a couple of good tries for Silver.
Yeah, he was tremendous, and that left the sidestep. What a prodigious step, you know, he shot off that left foot. He scored a couple of very nice tries.
And Isaac Gaffey there, up in Canberra this year, of course, and more reports, Warren, he had a pretty good game as well.
He did. There were a number of players. I thought Bruce Sinclair had a very good game for Eastern Suburbs too. He played well. I think he did about 34 tackles and took the ball up strongly all night.
That'll be all the stuff you thought in there as a Dalmo.
Oh, no, I take no credit for that.
Another battle.
There's a break down the corner ball from Gary Freeman for this try.
Yeah, well, Freeman's performance was interesting. I guess, Roy, are we maybe putting Eastern Suburbs down and maybe they might have a better season than we think?
No, I think that we're probably overemphasising St George a little bit. Eastern Suburbs always beat St George, even when St George had very good sides. Eastern Suburbs is the team that always causes the most problems. I think that there is too much pressure on St George.
Nice against East.
Well, I don't think we can blame Dennis for that. And he's a high tackle on Russell Wire.
You'd like to get his bank, Warren. You've got Bass and Wellington.
Let's have another look at this.
Well, he was out. Oh, there he is now. He's not the best, and virtually put him out of the game, that one. So.
Mentioned in reports, was it?
Oh, I don't know whether it was mentioned in the report, but it's worth mentioning that, it ought to be looked at. But I'm a bit worried after the Brisbane business in Wellington on Lydon and Linda, the two on it, that high tackling will be something. Otherwise, someone's going to get a 10-week suspension and pay the price.
A lot of mistakes from some very experienced men that we've seen already from Joe Thomas, and now Gary Freeman, who is certainly been doing good things for Eastern Suburbs, right?
Yeah, well, he's given them a lot of the organisation around the rucks, and obviously they're responding to it. But we've really got to look at Warren's side here. I think that's the talking point. I mean, some of the errors that they made were huge ones, and Joey Thomas had an uncharacteristically sort of dull game. Warren, I thought that he should have been a lot brighter than he was. Who's this taking the ball up there?
There's Joe now.
He acted very slowly to that hole, don't you think?
Yeah, a little bit slowly there, perhaps, and he made some handling errors, but he wasn't Robinson Crusoe. I think everyone in the team made errors.
Warren, we were speaking before the show. Do you think everyone's perhaps not giving East enough credit this season? I mean, a lot of people I've heard tipped them to be the wooden spoons, but they've certainly shown that that's not the case.
Yeah, and I mentioned earlier I was talking to Gary Freeman, and he said that, the people aren't giving East enough credit for their defence, and it's been my opinion. I just hark back to New Zealand days. When a side's been down and out for a long time and they get a smell that they might be winners, it can be a bushfire, that rages within them, and they'll be very hard. If they get another one under their belt next week, and watch the LA go in the premiership.
Yeah, youthful exuberance is a wonderful thing. It certainly can overcome skill and, experience at any stage. Who is here?
Well, I think, it's the youth that gets you the semis, but the experience that'll win when you get there, but you need that.
How many tackles has this guy?
Well, that's scandalous defence, but I still reckon there's a delicacy balanced formula in football that if you're asked to do too much defence by making a lot of errors yourself in attack, you're just on a course of self-destruction.
Sean Devine, why? Seems to be injured a hell of a lot, money.
Is there any relation to Andy Devine, mate, the old Hollywood actor?
Well, I don't know if that's a throwback to the day when they had time off for injuries, but those sort of ploys don't work anymore. Right. Maybe it's general. Give him benefit of the doubt. But there's two forward passes, not one.
Warren, how many games can a side afford to drop? in early rounds without really thinking about the danger for the five.
Well, last year we won our first one against the Gold Coast and lost three straight. And as you know, we made a plus. And interestingly enough, we were on 27 with a plus, 28.